Hello, welcome to Kids Invent Stuff, the YouTube channel where we bring to life kids' invention ideas. I'm Ruth.
And I'm Sean, and we challenged kids to send us their ideas for lockdown inventions. And we were sent some brilliant ones, including 6-year-old Evan and 4-year-old Xanthi's idea for a robot that plays music while firing out ice creams and ice lollies, and 8-year-old Anve's idea for a wheelchair that turns into a stretcher with a mini built-in TV, and 6-year-old Erin's invention for a robot that fires out soap and hand sanitizer to kill the coronavirus.
But because we're still in lockdown, this month we're going to be building 2 invention ideas. So the first invention we'll be bringing to life is, drumroll, 8-year-old Sakuko's social distancing outfit. It's this amazing outfit with these wings that come out if anyone gets too close, and this amazing skirt. Let's build it. Go!
Kids invent stuff.
To bring to life Sakuko's invention, we're going to create a suit with a hooped skirt and a motorized pair of wings that open up whenever a distance sensor detects somebody close by, and we'll power it all with a solar panel backpack.
So to build the structure of the wings, we're going to use some pipe, and we want the wings to be able to open and close, so we're probably going to need to put some hinges, probably some linear actuators. Let's make some wings. So we have pipe structure of our wing, and currently this is very long. From here all the way down there is 2 meters. It's quite heavy. And we've got this little hinge, if you can see. If you imagine it's like this, so it's attached in the backpack, the wing's kind of down, and then obviously the linear actuator will go across here, and it will open the wing out. Linear actuators are motors that push and pull, and we use them quite a lot in our projects. We even used one in our last build for the robot hairstyle chair. So we're gonna place the linear actuator. So what I've done is I've extended it as far as it will go, because what you want is you want, when the wings are open, for them to be a similar height and to have like nice height to them, but not be too high. So I'm going to place the linear actuator on one of the wings while it's fully extended, and then I'm just going to mirror, or try to mirror, where this one is on this wing on the other one. We'll also find out at this point whether the linear actuator is strong enough to hold all of this bit of pipe. I mean, you can't see the end of it, it's that long. Okay, so it's worked, it's lifted our wing up. The only thing is that this is taking a lot of weight. So we're gonna fasten our pipe frame onto this piece of wood, and we've created these metal brackets. So the long bolts are gonna go straight through, and then these holes are for screws to hold it straight into the wood, so that it'll support where we've attached the linear actuators to keep our wings upright. Okay, let's see if this works.
And then just one more thing I wanted to know. You take me
away. They're a lot lighter once they're in this than I thought they were gonna be. So we've got our pipe frame for our wings, and now we need some feathers.
So we've taken some red cotton and we cut it into long rectangles and ironed them. And then we've used this waterproof silicone to glue those two bits of fabric together with a piece of wire through the middle of it. So I started to lay out my feathers and this end bit of pipe here, one bit on that side. The room's not quite big enough for all of this, and there's another bit that goes underneath that set of drawers. The issue that I'm having is that they're still very big even when they're folded away. Cut this and have a feather come down that then gets pulled out, then actually I might be able to go through a door with these things on. No going back now. So to hide the piping, we're sewing and cable tying this little cover to go over the top of our frame. And then what we're going to do is we will join with string all the feathers together. And then as the linear actuators go up and down, each of the feathers will pull out and then close back in together. And we'll slightly overlap them to keep them in place. And then once we're happy with that as the basic wing shape, we'll cover it with feathers. So our linear actuators are built into our frame and we've got this little distance sensor. We need something that's going to hold all of this stuff together, and this is our Arduino. So we've connected everything to our Arduino, and if our distance sensor senses someone's too close, it lets the Arduino know, which then activates our relays, which are attached to our linear actuators. So essentially if someone gets too close, distance sensor picks it up and the wings open. Well, that's the plan. Let's see if all the programming and everything else works together. Okay, here we go. This is our little distance sensor. We have our Arduino. We have some linear actuators. We have a 12 volt battery to power the linear actuators. We have a lot of wires. And hopefully, if this works, when I connect this, and then when I activate, yeah! So that sensor set all of this off. Linear actuator's moving. Go, 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 go. The code works. Yay!
Now, one of the things we've been thinking about is where to mount our distance sensor. Now, looking at Tsukuko's drawing, she has this amazing necklace. So I thought, why don't we mount the distance sensor in the necklace? So part of Tsukuko's social distancing outfit is this incredible skirt. And as soon as I saw it, it reminded me of a hoop skirt. Now, a hoop skirt has been worn under lots of different garments for hundreds and hundreds of years. So if you see all the historical paintings with women with big dresses, often they're wearing some sort of hoop skirt or structure underneath that. So there's lots of engineering that goes into fashion, whether it's the design or the property of the material, the way the material's made, or the way that the material is put together. And a hoop skirt is a great example of this. So we're going to make our own hoop skirt using these hula hoops and some bits of pipe, and I'm gonna spray these black, and then we're gonna combine them together to create this hoop skirt structure. And you can see on the picture that actually you can see this structure through the bottom of the skirt. Let's make a hoop skirt.
So I've got my painted black hoops and I've got some bias binding and I'm about to start making my hoop skirt. Now usually these things are sewn and I'm going to offend a lot of textiles people here by making it with hot glue. I don't have a sewing machine here, so I'd have to hand sew it, which would take a long time, and actually this stuff is pretty tough to sew through. So I've done a little experiment with some spare pipe and the bias binding, and I've been quite impressed with how well it works. So I'm going to attempt a hot glue hoop skirt. Let's go. If I get through, please. Let's keep going. Come on, this way, this way. This way, you're lost in the skirt. Where have you gone? You're there. So we've got our hoop skirt and we've covered it with this red floaty material to form the skirt on our outfit. So Sakuko wanted a solar panel on the back of her rucksack. And so what we've done is we've taken a solar panel module and we've put some poppers in it, and we've put some poppers on the rucksack so that we can wire it in and popper it in place. And what that allows us to do is if it's sunny, then we can connect the solar panel and it can power our wings. So we finished building Sakuko's social distancing outfit, and all that's left to do now is to test it.
And a big thank you to the awesome folks at OKDo for supporting this invention challenge. And if you know any kids who might like their invention ideas built, then you can send them to our website, which will appear on the screen below. And don't forget to like this video and subscribe to our channel.
So we will see you next week. We'll be testing Sakuko's invention. See you then.
Bye.
Don't forget to like and subscribe.